play the classic here. We'll play the classic. Just lose a piece. Uh-oh. The bishop's actually blocking his b5 move, which he needs. Actually, I swear this is like how you win a piece, but if he goes a6, bishop here, bishop check, followed by b5, he saves his piece. That's weird. I always thought this was like a winning tactic. Maybe it's not. Probably want to get like bishop e3. Or, oh, okay, this also goes for trades. When you're up a piece, you want to trade. Looking greasy, dude. I am greasy. Caught me red-handed. Trades. I know I'm gonna fix his pawns, but trades are good. Four months, small PP energy. He's subbing at tier three, by the way. By the way. Small PP energy. It is a good thing to have. Your badge goes a long way. I'll just make an escape square. Have you been around for the last two nights of Marble Smoke? I think maybe you were here for one of them. I don't know. But like, yesterday was a crazy Marbles day. The day before that was Marbles. Believe me, Smucker, I notice. I notice, buddy. So in these positions, there's so many things to do, but I pretty much always find myself gravitating towards trying to arrange like a checkmating pattern with the knight and the rook. Honestly, I think it's kind of a good practice to get into. Yeah, I think it's good practice. Practice setting up mating nets and everything. Cause yeah, we could take pawns here. But I think it's good to know how to set up a mating pattern with any combination of pieces. Attacking my knight, I'm moving my knight, my pawn's hanging, and it defends his pawn. So I've actually just given up my... Whoa, that was weird. How did it do that? I've actually given up my whole queenside here, just trying to set up a mating net. The knight goes on f5. Here, maybe just here. Yeah, the knight goes on f5, h5, h3. I just didn't want him to play rook g2. I think I need all these pawns to do it properly, just in case he goes here. Gets to f5. This is pretty much all I need now. His king, you start to see how he gets mated here. Like, things are starting to get covered. Now we're covering this square. just take this, and if he keeps pushing, I'll put my rook behind the pawn, which is where it's supposed to be. I want to get this move in next. Yeah, and I mean, here it's just hard to refuse a free rook, but yeah. It means I would always be able to play this, and if his rook ever left the last rank, then we would have mate. So I think it's still useful to practice mating nets. I mean, if I check him and he goes here, then that's mate. And it's just gonna be forced mate here on g6. I mean, rook g8 is mate in one. The problem is if he moves the h pawn, then he still gets mated, but it'll just be on h6. And obviously, with 1.9 seconds and mate on the board, the most efficient way to do things, he's gonna flag, but the most efficient way to do things is to take with the king and play here to cover that square, let him queen, and then, only then, deliver mate. Or the other option, of course, you take with the king, let him queen, and deliver mate with the pawn. Either way. Hey guys, I'll let you get back to the video in just a sec, but I wanted to remind you that today's video is brought to you by manscaped.com. And for me, Christmas came a little bit early. I just got the new performance package by Manscaped delivered to me. There we go. Manscaped created the world's first all-in-one men's grooming kit. First of all, the Lawnmower 3.0. This has the advanced skin-safe technology by Manscaped. It protects you when you're shaving down below. It gives you a lot of confidence and safety. You don't have to worry about anything. So this thing is absolutely essential for taking care of your downstairs. LED light, flip that on. Get your buzz going. Nice little charging stand and you're good to go. We also have the Crop Preserver. This thing is a moisturizer, anti-chafing, so after you just use the lawnmower, go ahead and apply that real quick. You'll be feeling good for the rest of the day. Crop Reviver. This thing's also super important. If you're in a rush or you just want to, you know, quickly revitalize down there, boom, just a little spritz. Smells pretty good. That's all you need. You're on your way. The Weed Whacker. This is the latest addition to the entire package. LED light as well. This thing has the same advanced skin safe technology as the lawnmower. It's for trimming those pesky nose and ear hairs without worrying about anything. And if you pick up the performance package right now, then you will get not only a nice little travel kit here, but also this sweet pair of Manscaped underwear for free. Promo code CHESSBRAH, 20% off. And we know we got CHESSBRAHs everywhere. We got free international shipping to offer you guys as well. So 20% off with the code CHESSBRAH. That's something nice to add to your wish list for the holiday season. So hope you guys check it out and pick one up for yourself. But for now, I'll let you get back to the chess. So again, if you're watching KGN, Bogus, Skippy John Jake, Ojito, Frizzle Frazzle, Mame Slap, Mexican Mower, Disgruntled, Golfin. I mean, just let me know, guys, if you're here, but send your challenge in if you're watching. Oh, you're here, Bogus. Let's go. Were you playing core? You often get in for some of the core. We just did that. Yeah, I've been looking for you, Bogus. T-Gents, what's up? Thank you for the gifted sub, man. Very kind. Paying forward the gift sub they got from Tommy Fook and Chubby. You see, Tommy's a positive influence on the community. Okay, so the knight, bishop, and castle. You want me to give preferential treatment to the Argentinians? What clip are you? Oh, yeah. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, the Instagram clip. Well, I was able to pre-move guests and do a checkmate while taking a couple shots, so it was pretty good. It was pretty good. Alan, I'm playing Julian Rebellini. Going for another Instagram clip. See if we can squeeze any more content out of the live. Let's go here. Hey, Emblem. Hawaya. I'd like to get H6 in as well. Just nice to have an escape square. Don't need to rush here. No, Spenny. We were talking about my opponent here was the latest. He was in the latest Instagram clip, the one that was just posted. Hey, Hyperbolo. Okay, I think this is free, but I have to double check this. It is free, but it's a little tricky. So if he does this, the point is I can take this rook with check and then take back. Because if I took the rook back, he would take here and be winning. And if he moves the queen, well, I just won a pawn, so. Alrighty then, lad. That's a good username. Playing viewers. Crazy backlog. We're finishing up sub Sunday, so. People have already got their challenges in or joined the queue in Discord, and I'm just finishing up. Breadsticks, by the way, thanks for hanging around, or ASailor96. I appreciate everyone's patience who, you know, got their challenge in and still around to play their game now. This is awesome. I know it's been a long day. Try to fix these, you know, improve my pawns a little bit, gain a little bit more space, control over this square. I'm happy to trade knights. I'm probably gonna push some pawns over here, push some pawns over here. I have full control of the open file. Trades are fantastic. I'm gonna give a check. If he goes there, I'm gonna go walk my king out to e5. e5 is a really good square for the king because if he ever brings a rook here and here, can't ever attack my king. Like my pawn here takes care of my king on e5 pretty nicely. So let's give it another check. Just because if he keeps going up, he's not only losing pawns, but he might also get mated. Okay, so he goes there, and yeah. Okay, it's probably just simpler to win a pawn. I was gonna bring my king to e5, but now I don't need to. Should just be winning even easier. H4, rook H2, and you'll notice he has no open files. The only one on the board, I've covered all five of the entry squares, so he can't even use it. Okay, here, honestly, might not be a bad move. I think he's trying to create an open file, so I definitely respect that. If he goes A3, I'll just take it. You can have one check, but that a pawn is probably gonna queen. Definitely want this pawn over this pawn because now I got two connected pass pawns that are much further up the board than these ones. Okay, he wants the push here. I'm gonna be super, super annoying and go here. If he checks me, I'll go here. this pawn. Cleaning up all the pawns. He mails a dog. Here we just go there. Think. Probably b3 is the simplest. Start with a check. If he goes there, I think I want to do this and this. I'll look to take this pawn. If he goes here, I'm not sure. I might throw in another check. Here is ambitious. Well, I think I'll go here, just because if he takes g5, he gets mated with a pawn by force, which is kind of cute. No, never feel bad for picking up the bamboo stick. No. Can't feel bad. I think an underrated skill or something that is really useful in chess. I mean, there are 1,000 different ways to win this position, but after white plays this, I would say most GMs would be on the lookout for this move or this move because it creates a mating net with f6 and the king's trapped in there. Whereas most players, like, I don't know, under 2200, under 2000 would, I don't know, make whatever move, b3, b2. And it's winning as well, of course, but it's a really useful skill to be able to identify. It might not be by force, like after this, white could have gone there, but it's good to be able to identify mating nets in any position. Like identify, oh, if my opponent plays the worst moves or if he helps me, how is it possible for me to checkmate this guy? Because there might be a situation where I don't have 2 minutes 28 seconds, I have 10 seconds. And if I have 10 seconds here, maybe that's not enough time for me to win like this. Maybe king e7 is worth a try. So it's just like, sometimes it's by force, sometimes it's not, but being able to locate checkmating nets in regular positions, or I think it's a really useful skill.